Hi, in this video we will review the matrix functionality in LS Activity. So matrices are used to present availability based on the resources, and the user can set up multiple templates to view resources from different angles, so to speak. And here, for example, I have from the demo database setup that shows the activity resources, human resources to be specific, and the time interval, and then it displays the appointments as on the cells, on the matrix cells here. So I want to show you the setups related to this. So I can have multiple templates, and the user can have a specific template as a default, but then they can change between templates. If we take a look at this bar template, so you give each template a unique code, you give the description, you set the interval type for the availability, you can define if the resources are shown horizontally or vertically. You can also have fixed view. That's useful, for example, for marina slots or parking spots, so forth. And then you basically create a pause menu to present the availability, and that's used as a fixed template. Then you can set up the times which are going to be viewed in a template in the matrix, and then we come to the cell functions. So you can specify if a cell pressed, what it will do, if it opens the related activity or the related reservation. You can also have it run a specific pause command, which is normally then used to for customized features. And then you would set up the which pause command to run here. Then we have the time pressed. So this is when you click on the time intervals. Then we can have it view the activities or the reservations for that specific time. The same goes for the resources. So if you click on a specific resource, you would get related activities or related reservations for that particular resource. Drag and drop enabled. This means that the user could reschedule the activity based to a new time or a new resource. Then we come to the filter section. So activity type, this would specify what products, activity products, can be booked from that particular template. This is resource group filter. This specifies what resources are going to be shown, in this case the human resources. And then you can go to further filtering based on the resources, so if you're using the attributes. Resource location, here you can specify if this template is only for a specific activity location, or if you leave it blank, it's going to be used for the location of the current user, which is displaying, or who is displaying the matrix. Check resource schedule, here you can compress the view. So based on capacity of the resource, so if it's going to compressed the intervals or eliminate the resource if they're not having capacity on a specific date. Then we have the view settings for the presentation. So here, as in the POS, you can select skins to be assigned on the buttons. So these are skins already predefined in the standard setup. So you can assign them to the view of a resource, or the interval, or the unavailability, or the assigned skins, and so forth. You can specify how many days you are viewing at the matrix for single view. And then we have a number of scripts. So scripts, to give you more detail about those. So here the user can specify which fields to pull in from the table, or basically in this case the resource table. We want the code and the name of the resource. So the user can completely define what is going to be displayed on the matrix. The same goes for the resource. This was for the cell itself, where you're displaying the activity. The same goes for the tooltip. So when you're hovering over a cell, you will get a script that basically, in this case, is pulling information from the activity. And this script supports HTML setup or format. So you can use the HTML to format your view. We'll get back to that when we go to the matrix. You can have it the matrix automatically refreshed on certain intervals. You can specify the date format for when you're showing dates, and if we want to see a progress bar when we are redrawing the matrix. The glyphs are basically additional information you can put on a button in the top right corner, bottom left corner, and so forth. These are the same script mechanism as we're using for the captions and the tooltips. So you can create your own script and pick up any kind of information from the activity or the reservation. So if you go back to the view, then I'm going to show you the functionality in the matrix itself. So we have here a specific date. We can click on a date cell, switch between days, and then the matrix is redrawn. And note, it doesn't matter how much of the matrix is populated. It will always take approximately the same time to refresh the matrix. So I'm here also switching between dates using the previous date and the next date buttons. And you can switch between templates as we saw before, or have a fixed template assigned on a button. When I'm hovering over a cell, then we get this script, the tooltip script. So as you can see, it will show us the more detail for each activity in this case. We can reschedule moving the activity to a new cell, and then we get the refresh of the matrix to present the new view. We can also click on the cell, and then we can have it open the activity card. So let's just change that setup, and cell pressed should be open activity card. Yep. And we should be able to open up the activity card here. Yeah. So when we click on the activity in the matrix, it's actually opening up the activity behind it for more detail. So also we can create or new activities. So simply by just clicking on a blank cell, then we get a list of the client, or we can create a new client, or we can just go and select from the list, Hope Williams. And then I get the list of the activities based on the activity type of the template. So I'm just going to select the muscle 60 minutes. And we get a new appointment, and we just hit OK to confirm it, and the matrix is redrawn with the new information. Note, when I drag and drop, it might be refusing to drop or reschedule if the resource you are assigning the activity doesn't support or is not capable of handling that particular activity. So on other features related to matrices, so just a couple of setups which is good to know about here. In the activity setup, if we open up the activity setup here, nice features is that you can set up that the matrix is opening up in a new tab. This is quite useful when you want to have the matrix just as an open session constantly, that you can access the matrix. You can also define the profile which we use for the styling. So if you want to change the look and feel of the view, I'm just going to set some sample here, for example this one. And so this is the set base settings you can have for the activity, for the matrix, sorry. And then we can now open up matrix. So if you notice now, it opened up a new session. So we still have access to the role center here, but we have a new session for the matrix, which we can just have constantly open. And in this case, we are using the new hyperview to present the data. So you have full control of the look and feel of the matrix. And so you just the same settings as we have in the point of sale. So this is everything about setting up matrices in LS Activity. Thank you.